Ladies and gentlemen, today I'm gonna tell you how to put a tutor in each pocket. When I was 13, I failed a math exam. Not because I didn't study. I had my nose in the book for days. I did all the formulas. I completed examples from the guidebook. I did what I was told to. But when I entered the exam hall and received the question paper, I froze. My brain didn't work. My hands went cold and I couldn't answer a single question. And then the obvious thing happened. I got a 12 out of 100. I failed. That evening, my mark sheet came home. Everyone was yelling at me, like whatever happens in a typical brown family. I was sitting in a corner, ashamed, thinking that I've let everyone down. I was in tears. The last to enter home that day was my uncle. He came home from work. He took my exam paper into his hands and glanced at it. He then looked at me and said, "What went wrong?" I couldn't say anything. I just handed him my maths book and he realized that it was an exam on fractions. So he very quickly went to our dining room and got a roti, a typical roti that is made in a Bengali home. He got a roti and brought it to my study room. And then for the next 60 minutes, first he tore the roti into half and then into another half. For the next 60 minutes, he told me how fractions work practically. And in the meantime, fractions started to make sense for me. That was a turning point and a breakthrough. Because I knew how fractions were working, while my typical school couldn't teach me. Now think of this at scale. My uncle was patient and kind enough to help me out with my studies. It was one-to-one tutoring, right? But think of this at scale. We cannot put a tutor for each of our students. Like practically, there are 40 million SEDB students here in Bangladesh. We cannot put a tutor for each of them. However, if you think of this mathematically, here N represents the practical sort of attention and the private attention that you get while studying. The more private attention you get, exponentially or mathematically, the better your studies become. 1 out of 5 students in Bangladesh drop out before secondary education. That's 20% of our talent wasted. But these are not unintelligent kids. These kids are just because they lost their track in a chapter, topic, exam, or teacher along the way. Like I had my uncle, who was my breakthrough. He gave me one-on-one tutoring and helped me realize that chapter in fractions. Similarly, for each of these kids that they drop out, they have lost the track in between along the path, and they have decided to drop out. Now let me put this into perspective with a scientific study. In 1984, Benjamin Bloom did a study called the 2 sigma study, or what he typically puts as the 2 sigma problem. In the study, he took a class and then he divided it into 3 segments. The first segment of the class was just typical and normal. The second segment was very much narrowed with a 1:1, a very small number of teachers and tutors and students. And the third segment had just the students, just one-on-one tutoring with the students and the teachers. The students who had one-on-one tutoring did 2 standard grades better than the students who had just taught normally or typically. That is 98% improvement in performance on one-on-one tutoring when there is 1 teacher and 1 student sitting privately and getting private attention in their education. Think of this again. One-on-one tutoring is the private gold standard in private learning and education. It is the gold standard. So the typical class in Bangladesh has 1:40 students, 1 teacher and 40 students. Think of your school days. We all had 1 teacher and 40, 50, 30, 20 students teaching at once, right? But it should be 1-to-1. But we cannot practically put this into scale when there's no mastery learning. Now think of this. We live in the world of AI, but without AI, what typically was happening before AI, before the era of AI, was mastery learning. Mastery learning is a concept where you have a recommendation engine and the recommendation engine adapts to your learning patterns, your strengths, and your weaknesses. That's not even close to one-on-one tutoring what we have with AI. This was more like learning like a GPS, where you took the wrong route and it guides you to the right path. You took the right path, it helps you achieve more of that right path. But think of this, learning as GPS to the power n, where n is equals to 40 million students of Bangladesh. That's again unpractical, right? We cannot put a recommendation engine into every single hand of students in Bangladesh. But the reality for these 40 million students is they are cluttered, they're offline, they're unsupervised, and they're unmonitored. Think of this again. They are offline for the majority. However, what if we can put them uncluttered, we can get them resourced, we can get them supervised, and we can get them monitored all at once? That's when I launched Borno AI. It's a one-on-one, errorless, patient, and collaborative AI system that does uncluttered, resourced, supervised, and monitored learning. Let me explain this to you in more details. Think of it like an AI personal tutor that is curriculum-specific to the nuances of your curriculum. So we all study in a specific curriculum, right? Someone in NCTB, someone in IB, someone in Cambridge, someone in Oxford. However, these curriculums each has their own sort of context and knowledge bases. So with the power of AI, we can actually tailor the experience of these students toward the nuances of their curriculum. So as a result, they will get not a very generalized answer. They will get something that is very personalized and tailored to what they are learning and what the curriculum is teaching. Very aligned and one-on-one and collaborative while being errorless and supervised and monitored for all of the students at the same time. And the fun part, it's all done offline. So you don't need even an internet connection to get access to this AI model because it's locally hosted. I will show you guys a demo. For example, you can select your class and your subject in the beta. And then you can write whatever question you want, right? You can get the answers in no time, errorlessly and efficiently. You remember the 13-year-old boy who failed in this math test? That's me now. I got my breakthrough through one-on-one tutoring with my uncle. But if not everyone has that patient, kind, and caring uncle who is willing to teach them one-on-one at no cost, right? And we cannot even scale to that many teachers for that many students for one-on-one tutoring. So the best part with leveraging technology, we can actually put a one-on-one tutor in each pocket. One student, one screen, one app, one breakthrough at a time. Thank you.